Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video I am going to show you the project Sakura for this Redmi Note 3, which is based on Android version 10. So let's begin. As you guys can see here, the Android version here is Android 10. The security patch level here is you were the August 5th, and the build number here is the 5th of August. And the kernel here is the dirty bloody kernel, which is really a good kernel. So that is it. Now let's just go to the home screen, because this ROM has an exciting home screen we all wanted from years now, because the OxygenOS ROM is not available for this Redmi Note 3. And now this ROM, the home screen is the OxygenOS home screen. The default launcher you get here is the OxygenOS launcher. On the right swipe you get the never settle this page here, and as you can see it shows the step counter and everything, recent apps and everything. And the recent apps you get here is also from the latest OxygenOS 11. This recent apps panel here is also from the latest, as you can see here. So this is amazing. And on the long press, this is what you get in the home settings. These are the option, add your icon, add icon to the home screen. The swipe down for the notification access, like this. Like when you swipe down, this is how you get the notification access. Then on the leftmost screen, you can either get the shelf or you can also get the Google feed, whatever you want. Like on the right, this is I have set the shelf, and now you can just change it to Google feed. Just take it from here, and now as you can see the Google feed is available on the right swipe. So this is a great option available here. Whichever you want, you can just do that. Then you get a double tap on the home screen to lock. Then you get the launcher layout. Like if you want the drawer, then you can set it to drawer. And if you want the home screen, then you can do that also. Like as you can see, all the apps will be on the home screen, like MIUI. This if you are addicted to MIUI, then this is what the layout you will get. And on the swipe you will get the search bar. This is the option available here, but I'll just prefer the app drawer because it is more convenient and nice. Then the other settings here, you get the notification dot, this icon pack, you can just change it according to you. Then you get the home screen layout, the columns and the icon size, as you can see here, and the layout you get here. Then you get the hidden space available here, which is how you can access this. This is the way you can access the hidden space, and like this. This is the way, two ways you can access the hidden space. Now let's just go to the settings. I'll just show you the settings in the system. These are the options you get. The buttons options are available, the backlight option, the power menu option, whichever the options you want on the power menu. Then you get the long press for the torch, the home button, the long press and the short press. Customizations are volume buttons customizations. Going to system profile, these are the three options, default, silent and the automobile. Okay, then going to the status bar customization, these are the status bar, the quick pull down, the network traffic monitor, you can just enable it from here. This is how you can enable the, and then you get, these are the system icons. You can, if you want to enable the headset icon on the status bar, then this is the settings from which you can access it. Then you get the clock position, left, right, then you get the battery indicator styles, the battery percentage, the brightness slider. Then going to the gestures, these are the gestures. There is no system swipe gestures available. You get only these two, the jump to camera and the prevent ringing. These are the two gestures available. There are no swipe gestures, the Android 10 gestures available. Then this is the advanced control to the Xiaomi features available here. When going to security, there is no fingerprint option available for me, but there is some problem with my device. It will be available for you, so no worries. The fingerprint option will be available. There is no face unlock available here. So guys, then going to the privacy and stuff, these are all the privacy settings available here. Then going to the sounds and vibrations, these are the sounds and vibrations. These are just the same options available as every ROM, the vibrate for calls, the ringtones and the touch sounds, the touch vibration, everything is just available. Then going to the Sakura configs, these are the Sakura project customization. Going to the about project, these are the developers, the Lord Shenron and the Chaitanya Mittal. Arun Teltia is the web developer here. Then these are the official maintainers here. You can see these are the devices for which the Project Sakura is available here. As this is not the official one, so the Redmi Note 3 name here is not there. Then going to customizations, these are the customized interface. These are the themes you get, all the themes. Then you get the battery bar, you get the smart pixel option available here, the full screen apps also available. Then going to the animations, these are the animations, that's it, the activity open and activity close animation, that's it. Then going to the quick settings, these are the quick settings customization. You can set the quick settings opacity, as you can see I have set to 50%, now the 100%. So you can just set the opacity of the quick settings. You can get the quick tink toggle, you can get the custom header image, this is how it looks, and you can set the header image shadow from here. These are all the image collections available here. Then going to lock screen customization, these are the customization. You get the music visualizer, the status bar and everything customization. Then going to the gestures, you get the three finger swipe for the screenshot gesture available here, which is working, and the long screenshot option here is also working. But I don't know what is wrong. As you can see, the long screenshot option here is also working here. Then going to the notification, these are the notifications options available here. This is for the notification, you get the edge lighting available here. Then going to the miscellaneous, these are the miscellaneous settings. You get the signature spoofing, the sensor blockage, and the gaming mode is available. You can just customize the settings according to you, whichever the settings you want. Then you get the Sakura OTA. Here are the system updates OTA, but it just gets exited. As you can see, the settings just keep stopping. This is what happens when you try. So there will be no OTA updates because it is just broken. Going to the display settings, here are the display settings. The dark theme is available here. Going to styles and wallpaper, here are the styles. These are the clock styles available here. These minimals, the Samsung bold, everything is just available. Going to the wallpaper, this is the Sakura OS wallpaper. I have just changed it to OnePlus Nord wallpaper to get the OnePlus feel, the Oxygen OS feel. I have just changed it to that. Then you get the rotation settings, the font size, display size, double tap to wake, double tap to sleep. That is it for the display settings. Then going to the battery life here is just amazing. No worries with the battery life. As you can see, I charged it to around 95%. See, the screen on time is almost 131 minutes. For around 20% of battery drain, you will get around 1 or 31 minutes of screen on time. So this is how the battery life is. The battery life, then you get the smart charging, which is just not working. The battery saver and performance, here are the performance mode, the power saver, efficiency, balanced, quick and performance mode. So guys, that is it for these settings. Now let's just go to the home screen. Let's see the quick settings. The quick settings toggle, Wi-Fi is working absolutely fine, and mobile data for the Idea Vodafone SIM is working absolutely fine, no worries. The Bluetooth is working. Flashlight here is, as you can see, working absolutely fine. The battery, you got the battery saver, the airplane mode, the screencast, the hotspot, dark theme, nightlight, location, and the FPS info here is just not working. And you get the screen recorder, which is also working absolutely fine. Then talking about the camera, you get the Google Camera Go version available here. This is the default camera, the Google Camera Go version, which is working absolutely fine. As you can see, no worries with the Google Camera Go version. The portrait mode, video mode, everything is just working. Then talking about the Google Camera version 7.3, which is not working. I have installed the 5.1, which is available on the, this is the 4.1 I think. So this was available on the Play Store, you can just directly download it from there, and this is working absolutely fine. I prefer to use this instead of the Google Camera Go version because it has the better quality images and the better quality video also. So I prefer to use this Google Camera 4.1. Then talking about the other stuff like the PUBG performance. The PUBG performance is as usual great, no worries with the PUBG. We will be playing, and with the GFX tool you will be getting around 40 to 50 FPS. So just play with the GFX tool because without the GFX tool the performance is just not that great. Then in the recent apps, if you want to get the split screen, just press and hold on this. These are the options, you get the lock, app info and the split screen. This is how you can get the split screen option available here. Okay, then talking about the safety net status here as passed. So you will be able to run the banking apps, but you will have to install the Magisk Manager here. You will have to root your phone, so this is how you can run the banking apps. Then going to the Geekbench scores, the performance here is just amazing. Here are the Geekbench score, the 293 and 830. The scores are pretty much same as each and every ROM. Okay, so that is it. Then guys, there is an inbuilt weather app. The Oxygen OS weather app is available here, as you can see. This is the Oxygen OS weather app, so which is just working fine. And in the widgets, these are the widgets. You get the OnePlus widget. As you can see, the clock style here is the OnePlus clock style. So guys, that is it. So guys, before showing you the bugs, I would like to show you this app which should not be installed here. So just see to it. I have just hidden it, and this is called Neko Poi. This is what you call the porn app. The, as you can see, these cartoonish porn apps is a porn is available here. This should not be available. I'll just blur it out. And this is the pre-installed app, and I have just hidden it. You cannot uninstall the app, but you can just disable the app. As then talking about the bugs here, the bugs present here is the black screen bug, obviously present, but there is no random reboot bug. I haven't faced that bug, and I'm using this from around a week now, almost a week, from 26th August. So there is no random reboot bug. The black screen bug here is present, lock screen bug here sometimes you will face. There are so many bugs present here, so this is important to tell you. So first of all, I would like to show you, I have just screen recorded that bug. This happens a lot of time, that the quick settings just don't work. I have just screen recorded it from the third party screen recorder, because the quick settings just won't work. As you can see, I'm clicking on the Wi-Fi, the quick settings just, the toggles just don't work. As you can see, the flashlight I was clicking, it was also not working. The Bluetooth also was not working, and I clicked on the screen recorder also, as you can see, but the screen recorder was not getting started. So this is a bug present here, that the quick settings will not work. And I, as you can see, the Wi-Fi was on, and up here, as you can see, in the quick settings it was showing off. So just quick settings sometimes gets broken, but for that you don't have to reboot the phone. Just press and hold the power button, go to restart and reboot the system UI. Don't have to reboot the phone, just reboot the system UI. Then the another bug present here is the apps will not get opened. This I have recorded from the system screen recorder, which is available pre-installed. And as you can see, the Instagram is not getting open. This is the bug present here in each and every ROM. So this is a bug present here. The Instagram will not get open, the Facebook will not get open, it will just stuck at here. And that is it. And now if you just try to install the Facebook, this is what happens. I'll just show it to you. As you can see, I'm just uninstalling the Facebook, and now the icon will not go. It will just stay the same, and it will just, when I try to open it, it will just show you app isn't installed. So this is a bug present here. And for to overcome this, normal reboot will not work. You have to reboot using the power button and the volume down button. You have to force reboot your phone. This is how you have to reboot it. And then the another bug present here is in the restart. As you can see, the restart option is available, but if you click, the phone will not restart, it will just power off. So the restart button is just broken here. Then there is the other bug, the lock screen bug here is present, and the fingerprint option is not available for me. So guys, these were the bugs present here. Okay, so guys, that's it for now. If you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to hit the like button. If you are new to this channel, then please guys subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions, then you can ask me in the comment section below. I'll meet you in the next one. Till then, stay safe, have fun, and goodbye.